It got me wondering just how far young girls would go to be like their idols. The clothes show live in Birmingham seemed like the perfect place to find out. It attracts thousands of teenage girls, many looking to get spotted by some of the leading model agencies who scout there for new talent. I decided to set up my own experiment.
I don't really want anyone that's above a size zero. It would basically just involve cutting your calorie intake down by about 3/4, probably living off tomatoes and apples, probably one of each day, possibly a rice cake if you're feeling really faint. You know, well into the underweight category. That's interesting. So would you, as a model...
Yeah, probably.
You would go down for me?
Yeah.
Wow, brilliant. Because I'm looking at girls that are right down there, you know, bones popping out all over the place and that kind of stuff. I'm kind of looking for models who will eat next to nothing. Because I think the rest of the industry is going to start making their models get bigger, and I'm not. I'm like, they're staying down. You know, those kind of people. Would you conform to that?
Yeah, I think so.
You think so?
I would later tell all the girls we came across that it was an experiment, and I didn't really want them to lose any weight.
Put your hand up if you want to be a model.
Me? Yeah, no, I will.
And what would you all do to be a model?
Anything.
Like, what if I was an agent and I said to you, right, girls, you're all too fat, you've got to lose about 2 stone, you can live off an apple.
You'd go to the gym.
You'd go to the gym.
Salad.
You would?
Yeah.
You would. How much weight would you lose?
As much as you told me.
I mean, that's what a hell of a mindset to try and change. That's just really upset me. I couldn't believe how many of them said yes. It's the fact that all those girls were gorgeous and absolutely didn't need to lose any weight at all. They just want that lifestyle.
It was suggested by friends that owning a fabulous designer outfit that didn't fit might motivate me to shift a few more pounds. So I set to work on creating my very own size zero dress. I sought out some young designers at a top school of fashion who agreed to help me.
I look at this and I just think that looks really Victoria Beckham, like with the whole kind of big leg coming out and the slinky, you know, slinky dress. Mm. And I really like that.
The dress would be ready by the end of my diet.
Come on. More again.
It was the halfway point. I'd managed to lose 9 pounds.
As far as you can personally take your body to, and maybe it will never get there.
500 calories a day, obviously, isn't going to get me there, so I've got to have just drink something for a couple of days.
And that something was maple syrup, the diet that Beyoncé used to lose 20 pounds in 10 days for a role in a movie.
It's not that bad. I mean, it's probably the oddest thing I think I've ever drunken.
I'm like, I'm drunk all the time. Just walking around. I just want some food. My mouth was made for food.
My own quest to get down to a size zero was not going to plan. I'd got to 5 weeks into the diet and I'd lost a whopping 9 pounds.
That is so close. But I think, I don't know, I can't quit now. Think it works?
The weeks of extreme dieting and extreme exercise were affecting my mood, and my social life was suffering.
I'm really shocked at how unhappy I feel and how depressed I feel. I know what it's like to be on the receiving end of people that are like this, and it's horrible because you don't ever know where you stand, you don't know what you've done wrong, and it's me doing that now.
You know, up the road for...
I'm in this zone where I'm just like, just leave me alone. I only want to be on my own, and I deserve this time because I'm hungry. You know, it's like this kind of... You feel like you deserve to do it. You don't deserve to be like that at all. So then I come out of it, and like I said, I feel horribly guilty, and then I'll be in a great mood. But then everyone that I was with when I was in the bad mood's gone, probably thinks I'm a complete arsehole. Another guaranteed weight loss diet I came across was the cabbage soup diet. A delicious cocktail of boiled cabbage and not much else.
I'm so bored of this. I'm so bored of this. And sure, I probably lost a few pounds since I've been on it, but my tummy's so swollen. It's like really sticking out. And the side effects are slightly unsociable. I've got terrible farts. My cat won't sit with me, and she certainly won't sleep in my bed. I think I might stop the cabbage soup diet.
I spent Christmas with my family in Guernsey.
It's Christmas Day and we've got people coming for lunch and I'm just absolutely dreading it. Sitting around that table for 2.5 to 3 hours while trolley loads of food get put in front of me and I can't eat any of it, apart from a little bit of turkey and a few Brussels sodding sprouts.
I don't forget you've got the Christmas turkey.
Okay, so for me, can I just have one slice?
Right.
That's all I'm allowed. You go ahead and fill everybody else's plates up. Enjoy it, you fatties. Hello, everybody. Look at that. Look at that spread.
There we go.
Oh, it's green, it's green. I can eat it. Beans are actually quite high calorie, everybody, by the way.
Okay.
And that's it, I can't have any potatoes or parsnips or anything.
Which are the high carb ones?
So that's my Christmas dinner. Brussels sprouts, peas, beans, and a little slice of turkey. It's gorgeous.
Now they're all having cheese downstairs and dessert now. I've got 4 different desserts, of which I won't have any, so I'm gonna have a peppermint tea. I will never, ever have another skinny Christmas. Ever.
When I got back home, I was contacted by my doctor. Before Christmas, she'd taken some routine blood tests, but the results had come back, and she was concerned.
I mean, obviously, one of the reasons for seeing you again today was the fact that last time, the time before, your white cell count was just ever so slightly low. And the reason why that's important is that your white cells fight infection. The other thing that has come back as being low is your antioxidant capacity, which we were worried about might become a bit low. What antioxidants do is they have very potent anti-cancer properties. And, you know, with your family history, to have low antioxidant capacity is not a good thing. Mm-hmm. So what we just need to do is make sure that if they're dropping further, then, you know, my best medical advice would have to be that you stop.
Really?
Yeah. And you keep letting your white cells drop, and then there's a risk of significant infection. Things like tuberculosis you're more likely to pick up. Not just, you know, a bit of a cough or a cold, but, you know, serious significant infection. If you pick something up and this became a long-term problem for you,
Yeah. Then
I wouldn't have done my job.
OK, I do respect that.
So, you know, I can only give my best advice, just like what you would do with any patient,
yeah.
And ultimately it's your decision.
For me now, when I've come this far, when the end is in sight, like it is, I couldn't stop now.
Mm.
And if I was doing this for a job that I wanted, or to get into a certain size dress, or as a lifestyle choice, I wouldn't just stop. So for the sake of this experiment, okay, we'll see what it is, but I won't.
I'd always known that going on an extreme diet would never be healthy, but I had no idea it could have such serious implications.